For a data scientist, the data is everything, and that is why the source of data is very, very important. For making a good business decision, a data scientist should be able to extract data from the various sources, like Excel file, from the social network like Facebook or Twitter, or CSV file, from the in-house RDBMS database, from the PDF file, etc. So in this session, we are going to learn on how to extract data from the various sources. So first, we will start with the importing the test file. So you are already aware of the cust dimension file. So I have it as a text file. So let me show you the cust dimension text. Okay, this is my cust dimension file. This is a text file. If you see, the fields are actually separated by a tab. Now there might be a file where the fields are separated by comma, or the files, there are some text file where the fields are separated by colon, etc. So in this case, our field is separated by tab. So what I'm going to do here, we have to mention the file name custdimension.txt. Separator for tab is slash t tab, and encoding is ISO 8851. So once I execute it, I get this data. So now this will be stored in a data frame, and from here you know how to play with the data. Now reading data from the database. So in this example, I'm going to take the Oracle as my source data. So I have already an Oracle in my system, but usually your DBA will be able to provide you the information for the connection. So let me show you how we can find the connection. So I have Oracle connection. So from here, okay, if you are aware of the Oracle database structure, so here I have a host name, which is a local host. If your database is in the server, it will have an IP address of the server. Port is 1521 and my database name is XE. Username is system, and you should be knowing the password as well. So taking this connection credential into the Python. Okay, now for database, we have this library cx_oracle. And for MySQL, the library is pymysql. So first, let's start with Oracle here. So here, this is my TNS name, and local host is my IP address. 1521 is the port. Service name is XE. This is just we saw now in the example. And then after assigning this dsn_tns variable with this information, connection information, so we have to use a connection function where we will mention the username, which is system, password, APAC at the rate of 1234, and dsn, dsn time, tns. So once connected, we'll execute one table, so start from employees. So let's see. Okay, so the connection is successful, and we can see the record from the select star from employees. So same query I can execute in my database. So here also I have a 8 rows here. Same way for MySQL, you can make the use of pymysql. And the connection strings are like this: localhost, root, your password, word, etc. So now I'm reconnecting to Oracle database, and I will move all the data of select star from employee into an employee data frame. So let us see the data type of the employee underscore data here. So this is a list. So you can select the first 5 records here. Now this list you can convert to data frame so that it is easier to do a data analysis. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use the function data frame, and then you have to define the column name here, f name, minute, last name, SSN, etc. So once done, you have this data as good as the RDBMS data.